Hello everyone, welcome to Coding Techniques. Today we are going to build the planned application part 2, and this is a design which we have already built. You can see out here. Alright, now if you want to build this project, then there is a link out there at the top right corner. You can click on that and it will redirect you to a video which I have already created for the first part of the planned application. You can download the code and set it up as I have done out here. Now let's jump to the code out here. I'll set it up a bit nicely. So I'll just type ionicgpage/auth and it will create the page auth. Now I'll copy from homepage HTML to the auth page HTML because I don't want to use the homepage, right? And then to the CSS also I'll change the URL. Then I'll simply copy the auth login and paste it in my auth folder and delete the homepage. Once that is done, what I'll do, in fact, I'll create another page called login within my auth page, and I'll change the routing out there. Then what I'll do from the user login, I'll copy everything to the login. And once I did that, what I'll do, I'll simply remove user login. All right. Now I'll change the router link to login and I'll give a image tag instead of the ionList header, nature love, and let's check it out. In my assets folder I have a lot of images which I'll be using right now, so I'll just comment ionList header from the CSS also and translate to 15 VH. Now to the image tag I'll give it a background of white. Let's check it out. Right, then I'll give it a height of 20 VH, border radius to be 50%, and margin bottom will be 8 VH. Okay, the URL is wrong now, it is corrected most probably. All right. Okay, out here I've given the name. Okay, it should be router link / auth. It is still not coming up. Let me just check the name of it. Alright, the name is native. It should be nature love. Now it is coming up. So this is set up nicely now. Now we will work with the tabs page. So I will create a page called tabs within the pages folder. And I'll create the home page also out there. Then I'll create a wishlist page and then account page. Alright. Then I'll also create an item page for the single plant screen. All right, now once that is done, I'll change the redirect to tabs by default, and in the tabs routing module I'll have a children. Within that I'm going to pass all the path, say like home page, account and wish list. I'll move it to the children one. All right, and then I'll change the items path to item/id, and this will denote the id which I'll pass dynamically. Now I need to pass a default path also, so path empty string, then redirect to by default will be /tab/home, and then path match will be full. So once this is done, let's check it out. All right, we are getting the result, but we need to show the tabs. So for that I'll open the tabs page HTML, or let us first set up the theming. For that I'll go to the theming section in the Ionic docs and go to the color generator out there. To the primary one I'll give the color 00A46C, to the secondary 00FF00, then to the tertiary let me give B1E5D3. Alright, once that is done, I'll simply go down and copy the primary, secondary and tertiary color and paste it in my themes variable.scss, replace it in the root. Alright, once that is done, I'll go to the ion tabs in the components and there we go. Now let's go to the users and copy the ion tabs and paste it in my tabs HTML. Once that is done, let's make the necessary changes. I'll give it an identifier tabs. Let me change the tab button to be home icon to be rows outline, similarly wish list, and this one will be third outline. Then account person outline, and I'll remove the last one. Then what I'll do now, let's check it out first. Alright, it is coming, but we need to make certain changes out here. I'll remove the badges, the label also, I'll remove it everywhere. Alright, let's check it again. Now it is coming up, but I want this to be outlined only when that is not selected. So for that, I'll check iron tabs did change event. I'll trigger it out and we'll check the gate current tab. Now for that, I have to initialize a property selected tab, which is of type any, and then I'll use the view child to access my iron tabs in this manner. Just check it out. So I'll pass tabs, static false, then property name will be tabs and it will be of iron tabs type. Let's import it up. Once that is imported, what I'll do, I'll create a function called set current tab. Within that, I'll use this dot selected tab will be equals to this dot tabs dot get selected function will be called, and it, as you can see, this is coming up in the suggestion because we are using the view child. Now I'll console this selected tab and let's check it out. What is the value of it? Alright, as you can see, the value is coming up. Now I'll simply make the changes out here in the iron icon. I'll make it an input attribute and then I'll make it a string everywhere. Now I'll check if selected tab equals to home, which is the tab name. Then what I'll do, I'll have the icon to be rows. Otherwise it will be rows outline. Similarly, I'll do the same process for the other icons also. You need to wish list, this will be hurt, and then account, then this will be person. Let's check it out. Alright, this is working. I'll click on the rows and that is working nicely. Alright, so we have set up it our tabs page nicely. Now it's time to work with the home page. Now in the home page, in the iron header, I'll pass an iron list, lines will be none, and I'll pass a class iron no border to my iron header. Within the iron list, I'll pass iron item, to which I'll pass a color of primary, and then within that I'll have an iron icon, slot will be start, and name will be reordered to. After that, let's first check it out how it looks like, and it is coming up, that's great. Now I will have another iron item to which I'll pass the color to be primary, and then I'll have an iron label where I'll write hi techniques. Techniques will be the username, whoever the user is will be written out there. You can have the content dynamic also. Now I'll have an iron author, the slot will be n, in within that I'll have the image tag. Within the image, the source will be sx/img/naturelove.png. I'll use the logo which I've shown out there, and this is coming. Now I'll have a div within which I'll pass a class popover, and I'll have the iron search bar out there. Now I'll have the iron header with to which I'll pass a background to be light color, and to the iron list I'll pass a primary color, and I'll also pass to the iron list a border radius of 00 20 pixel 20 pixel, then a padding bottom of 7 VH, iron item. What we need to do out there, I'll access the iron label to which I'll give it a font weight of bold and font size of 1.2 rem, and a letter spacing of 0.5 pixels. Let's check it out how it looks like, and there we go, it is coming up nicely. Now we need to align our iron search bar. For that, I'll access my iron avatar first to the image. Before jumping to the search bar, we have to work with our logo. There we go, you can see the white background, now it's fine. Now we can work with the iron search bar, and for that I'll access the div class popover, to which I'll pass the margin 0 and 8 pixel. Then the iron search bar, I'll give it a border radius of dash border radius to be 20 pixel, and margin top to be, let's say, minus 30 pixel, and it will move up now. Let's check it out. There we go. So we have achieved the iron header nicely, whatever we needed. Now let's jump to our iron content. In the iron content, I'll have an iron grid, which I'll pass the class iron margin top. Within the iron grid, I'll have an iron item, to which I'll pass lights to be none and color to be light. Now within that, I'll have an iron label class. Let's give it a title class, and I'll name it as popular. Now I need a iron button also. The slot will be iron, size will be small, shape will be round, color will be primary, and I'll name it as view all, which will be placed at the right side. Let's check it out. There we go, it's coming. That's great. Now after that, I'll have an iron draw. Within that, I will have iron slides, to which I'll pass some options, which will be dynamic options. And after that, I will have an iron slide. Within that, within the iron slide, I will loop it up with the items of an array, which I will call it as popular items. I'll declare this property out here, slide options at first, to which I'll pass an object where I'll pass slides per view to be like say 2.2. So we'll have 2.2 slides in one view. Then I'll have popular items of type any array to be of empty array. Then I'll have featured items, similar array, empty array. Then I'll have slide options 1. And there I'll pass slides per view to be 1.3. And this is it. So we have set up our TypeScript nicely. Now I'll create a service called API within my services folder and within the API folder. Let's go to our home page as CSS, and there in the iron content, I'll pass the background to be light color. And to the title, let me give it a font size of the same one, font weight to be bold and font size to be 1.2 rem. And I'll pass the color to be dark. And after that is done, I'll work with the iron slides, to which I will have an iron card. Let's do that first. So within the iron slide, I will have an iron card, and within the iron card, I'll pass first a class BG card, and the router link which I'll pass is slash at first, then depths, then I will have the items, and then I'll pass the dynamic value of the ID, which I'll have in when we are looping it up. Alright. Now once that is done, I'll have iron card header, within which I will pass the iron label, and I'm going to have the name out there, item name, in this manner, property binding. Let's check it out. You won't see anything out here as of now because we do not have any data. So in the API service, let's create some data out there. So I'll have a property out there, items of type any array, which I'll initialize to an array of objects, where I'll pass ID equals to 1, name will be, let's say, aloe plant, the price, let's say 700 rupee, and let me give it a category to be India. You can pass any value you like, I'm just giving it up, and the image, I'll be using it from the my assets folder, aloe.png. I already have it out there, you can just check it out. Alright, I'll copy and paste it 2 more times, and I'll change the ID, it will be ECHEVERIA, price will be, let's say, 500, and the last one I'll change it to USA, and it will be snake plant. So you can, I'll also change the image also, and you can even change the category, or you can pass country also, whatever your data you like, you can just have it. Now I'll inject it in my constructor of homepage TypeScript and import it up. Once that is done, we are good to use it up. And I'll initialize my popular items to be this.apiService.items. Similarly, I'll do the same for my featured items also. There we go. Once that is done, we will have the data. Let's see what is the result of it. And we are can see some data is coming up. Now, rupee symbol. Let's have the rupee symbol out here. And I'll pass item.price. Now I'll access the card content. Within the card content, I'll pass the img tag. The source will be item.img, and it will be dynamic. It will be an input attribute. All right. Now, what after that is done, within the iron card, what I'll do, I'll have a height of 30 VH, width to be 100%, and border radius to be, let's say, 10 pixels. Then the iron card header, let's work with that. I'll have the iron label and ptag to be of font weight and to be same as the earlier one, title one, 1rem, and font weight to be bold, 1.2 will be little more, and the color will be dark. And to the iron content, image will be have a height of 20 vh. I already have a BG card to which I'll pass a background image of, I'll pass the URL as the link to the assets, and then I'll access how nicely it is to access it up. Alright, as you can see out here, suggestions are coming up. Then I'll pass a position to be fixed, repeat, no repeat, then background size will be contained. Let's check it out, how it looks like. Alright, this is coming up. Look at this, this is too good. And the search bar is also working. After that is done, what is the next thing that we need to work on? What I'll do is I'll simply copy this iron grid and paste it again. Out there I'll make the necessary changes, make the title to be featured plans. Options will be slide ops 1. The array name will be featured items. And what else do we need to change? Okay, it will be an inverted commas. The iron label, I'll remove it, and I'll move the img tag within my iron card header. Now within the iron card contained, I'll have an iron item to which lines will be none. What else do we need to pass out there? Well, I'll pass an iron label within which I'll have the name and a p tag, within which I will have the iron text to which I'll pass a color of tertiary, and I'll pass the category out there. Now after the iron label, I'll access the iron text to the which I'll pass a slot of end, color will be primary, and I'll name it as, I'll pass the price out there. Alright, and I'll make it bold also in this manner by passing the b tag. Now I'll pass a class of price to my iron text so that I can customize it up a bit more. Let's check it out. Alright, this is coming up, but the design, I don't want it to be in this manner. So I'll pass the class to be featured instead of BG card, and I'll access it about here. Now within that, I'll have the height to be 40 vh, iron card header to be, padding to be 0, and I'll show you guys how, what is to be done out there. Let me comment it up for the timing. And the background, I'll give it as, I will give it a color of tertiary. To the image, I'll give it a height of 30 vh. Now let's check it out. Alright, this is coming up, but I think I need to uncomment the padding to be 0. Let's check it out. Now it is coming nicely. I'm very much happy with that, but we need to work with the price. I'll give align cell to be end, margin top to be, let's say, 11 pixel will be good. And there we go, it's coming up nicely now. That's great. So with this, we have successfully implemented our landing page. Now let's jump to our items page, single item page, and you can see we are able to go to the single item by clicking on any item. Now in the item page, what I'll do, in the TypeScript I will pass an object of type any, a property of type any, and then I'll inject the nav controller out there. In fact, I'll inject the router, activate route also, and I'll also inject the API service. All are imported. Once that is done, in the ng-on-init, I'll access the route.param.map.pipe, take one, so that I can have only one value of it, even if I subscribe to it, all right? And import take from rxjs operators. Alright, once that is done, I'll subscribe to it, and I'll have the param map within which I'll console the value of the param map. And then I'll check if param map dot has ID is not true, then I'll simply navigate back, because we do not have, if you do not have any ID, then how we can go ahead with the design, right? And I'll create a constant called id param_map.get_id. Then I'll have the console log, and within that I'll pass the id, and then I'll initialize my item to apiservice.get_item, where I'll pass the id, and I'll console this dot item. Now this get item, we need to declare it up, so I'll go to the api service, let's create it up, and out there I'll pass the id, I'll create a constant item and I'll find that ID within my items array in this manner, and then return the item which I'm getting out there. Alright, so let's check the output, and this is very important to get to fetch the ID, because I'm passing the ID in the router link and we are getting the ID, as you can see out here, and we are getting the data also. So that's great. That is how we need to do when we want to work with the dynamic content. Now in the HTML, let me pass full screen to true. To my iron content, I won't need any iron header. Then I'll have an iron grid where I'll have an iron row, and then I'll create two iron column of size, one of size 3, one of size 9. And after that is done, to the one that is of size 9, what I'll do, I will pass an iron slides, to which I'll pass phaser to true, and then iron slide within that. Within that, I'll pass the image tag, and source will be item.img. Now once that is done, to the iron slides, I'll pass ng4, 1,2, so because I want to loop it up 2 times. Alright, let's check the output now. Alright, we don't see any output. Let's go to the CSS first and try to design it a bit. To the iron content, to the iron grid, within that I'll pass padding to 0, iron row, I'll pass height to be for 70 VH. To the iron column within that, I'll have padding to 0, and iron slides I'll access it up, to which I'll pass a height of 100%. And then to the image tag, I'll give width to be 100%, height to be 100%. And I'll also have a background where I'll pass the color to be tertiary, so that it will look nice. Right, and I'll also access the bullet color, which will be available in my iron slides, and to which I'll pass a color of medium by default, and the active one I'll pass a color of white, and for that I'll use primary contrast. Alright, there is an issue with my iron slides, it will be let any name of that array. This is one of the ways, and there is another way, I can remove the ng4 and have the items. In this way also it will work, but this is not the proper way when you're using the dynamic content. So I'll remove the second slide and have this ng4 again, and it is coming up nicely. Alright, now let's work with the design. Why it is not coming up the bullet? Alright, this is I think iron color medium, it should be iron dash color medium, that's fine. Now I'll pass a border radius of 40 pixel at the top left and 40 pixel at the bottom left. That's good, that's great, it's coming up. Now let's work with the iron column of size 3. I'll have an iron button, fill will be clear, class will be iron margin, and I'll pass a click event to it also, which where I'll pass navigate back, and I'll pass an iron icon, slot will be icon only, name will be arrow back because I want a back button, and then the color will be dark. Let's check it out how it looks like, and it is coming up. That's great. If I click back, I'm able to go back, and navigation is working nicely. Now I'll pass a div, and within that I'll have an iron button, color will be primary contrast, and class will be iron margin. Now I'll pass an iron icon within that, to which I'll pass a slot to be icon only, and the color will be, name will be sunny, color will be primary. I'll copy it 3 more times, change the name everywhere, thermometer outline, water outline, the last one will be snow outline. Let's check it out how it looks like. Well, you can play around with the data as you like, you can pass a click event to it also and have some functionality to it also. I've just given it for a design purpose. Now I'll access this div, and within that I'll access the iron button, to which I'll pass margin top to be 5 VH, and to my iron icon, let me give it a font size to be 2 RM, I want it to be bigger, and now it is coming up nicely. Alright, now once that is done, I'll access the iron item after the iron grid, to which I'll pass lines to none, and class will be iron margin vertical. Within that I'll have an iron label where I'll pass the name, item name out there by using the property binding, then the p tag similar to the one which we have done earlier in the landing page, right? Similarly, color will be tertiary,
I'll pass the category.
And then after the eye label, I'll access the class price. Color will be primary and slot will be end. I'll pass in B tag. Within that, I will write, I'll have the price. All right. Once that is done and it is coming up nicely, let's align it up a bit. So to my iron item, to the iron label, let me give it a font size of say 1.4 RDM. I want it to be bigger and I want it to be bold also. Now I'll access the price class, align cell to be end and margin top to be let's say 15 pixels. And font size to be let's say 1.2 RDM will be good. There we go. It's coming up and it's looking nice. After that is done, I'll access my iron footer to which I'll pass class no and no border. And within that I'll access the iron toolbar within which I'll have an iron row and an iron column of size 6. Two iron columns actually of size 6. And class will be iron text center and I'll pass another class to the, for the first iron column to be iron to be by. And within the iron column, I'll have an iron button, fill will be clear, color will be light, and I'll name it as buy now. I'll copy it and paste it again. Like I said, I'll be using two iron columns. I'll change the color to dark and I'll name it as description and I'll remove the buy class. And it is coming up, but I cannot see the first column. Why? Because we have to do some designing out there in the buy class. I'll give it a background of dash dash iron color primary and the border radius to be let's say 0 10 pixels 0 0. Let's check it out and it is coming up nicely. It's all coming up nicely. Everything is working as expected. Navigation is working right, the scrolling, the slides are working nicely. So we have successfully implemented the design and it's looking pretty good. And if you click on anyone, it is redirecting you to the particular single item page. And that is working pretty nice. So I hope you have understood this part, how we have done that. If you like the video, kindly subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. And if you really like the video, please share with your friends. And it will encourage me to build more interesting videos as such. So see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much.